guys and to all of my kings and queens doing tremendous things. I am Altitude, representing Building the Reminds, the Hip Hop Workshop, renovating minds one rhyme at a time. And today, I got a special guest on this episode of Soundcheck, the talented, incomparable wordsmith to my left over
thank
here.
You, thank you.
Wuzi.
Thank
What's
you,
up, Wuzi?
Thank
appreciate
you, man. How are you, man?
Appreciate you, man. So, before we get into what I want to talk about as far as like your music and what you got coming out and stuff like that,
yeah.
I just wanted to have like a dope conversation among artists. So, basically, before we get into anything, like, because, you know, for those that don't know, I met him at an open mic, you know, out in the cliff, you know, shout out to Wayne, you know what I'm saying?
Man, shout out Wayne, man.
Yeah.
Hilarious, bro. Shout out Sticks, too, man.
Oh, Sticks. Yeah.
Shout out Sticks.
I would love to get Sticks on the show.
That would be hilarious.
That fool is hilarious, man.
Nova, too, man. Nova was extremely nice.
Yeah, she was super dope with the words, man. My first question to you is, who are some of your inspirations that have helped you become the artist that you are?
Oh, man, that's easy. Mm-hmm. Kendrick, off top, Eminem. When I was a kid, bro, that's mm-hmm. actually the first rapper I started listening to.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, because and okay. It's crazy because I'm from Detroit, so people like, oh, you from Detroit. Nah, it's actually not the case at all. So, like, I used to listen to a lot of, like, different genres when I was, like, a little kid, like R&B, jazz, rock. So, one day, I was like, and I had, as a youth, I had anger problems, so when I heard Eminem, I was like, oh, shit.
Do you remember the first song you heard?
I want to say it was The Sauce by Eminem. It was that Benzino diss.
The Benzino diss.
Yeah, and
okay.
Like the one where he like went, and I was like, yo, what is this? Like, so yeah, Eminem has been vital since day one. Ye is all the okay.
Yo, definitely Ye. Yeah.
Pac, man. Oh, how could I forget Pac?
Yeah. For me, it's like, all right, you got like KRS, you know, KRS-One. Lupe is my favorite rapper.
For
sure. I said some inspirations. I even told you this at the show. Like one of my like newer inspirations, because it wasn't from the old school, but like you remind me your style, the way you rap. I told you, yeah, you remind me of Joey Badass.
It was crazy, man.
As soon as I heard you rap, I was like, Joey.
It's like I love Joey, man. I absolutely love Joey, but I feel like sonically where I am and sonically where he is it might be ego, man. I don't feel like
so who would you say, like, you know, because we all want our own sound and everything like that, but
so,
like who's somewhere you live like, okay, like I got inspiration from, like sonically, like,
oh man,
I kind of sound like this person.
Yeah, because the thing about it is Ye has influenced everybody over the last 15 years or so, man. And Ye, as far as his ear for music, he has the same type of ear for music that I have. He likes the same type of things that I like. I study producers, and because when I'm making beats and when I'm going through looking for samples or whatever, I like, okay, how would this producer make this? How would this producer make this? How would this producer make this? And for me, Ye is the pinnacle.
Okay.
So I'm like, okay, when I make something, if I can't see Ye giving me the approval or the hate or giving me the,
you know, do that little head.
If I can't see Ye doing that, then I throw it away, man.
So do you end up with a lot of, so you throw it away, do you end up with a lot of Lucy's? Like,
yes.
Just a lot of tracks on your computer? Like, I feel every artist got like 1,000 songs sitting on a hard drive that we just never release.
Yeah, but for me, I work a little bit different. Like,
okay.
I only move when I'm inspired.
Oh,
so what you hear,
okay.
What you hearing is like what I'm writing, and it's not like I'm giving you everything that I'm doing, like the beats that I'm making.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for instance, bro, I went through a span in a month where I made 20 beats, and I used 5 of them, 6
nice.
Of them.
So you make your own beats?
Yeah. Oh,
nice.
Yeah, man.
Nice. Okay.
Yeah, man.
Like, it's
an overcharge for these whack ass.
Right. Hey, when you doubt, you gotta do it yourself, man. Like that. That's why I started recording myself back in like 2016, because I got tired of like paying engineers who didn't know what they was doing, or they did know what they was doing, they were super talented, but they want to overcharge for it too. And I'm just like, you know what, let me go on YouTube, let me go on some of these, like, let me DIY, like, buy the equipment, learn to do it myself, and I ain't got to pay nobody.
My thing about it was, is because I'm looking at these YouTube beats, and I'm like, bro, these beats are kind of what I want, but not really what I want. And then, like, you charging me $600 for the exclusive, like, when I can go and make a better beat, like, right. I just start teaching myself how to do it, bro, just playing around with the software, bro, playing around with sounds, and
okay,
bro, within like a year and a half, I taught myself how to make beats.
Everything that we want, we can do it ourselves, but also we need to, like, just start networking and moving forward with other artists. And that was one of the reasons why, you know, I started doing this interview process, you know, and it's not just for musical artists, but I want to get more artists on here. I appreciate you being the first music artist on here. Because it's like, there's so much talent, like, in the DFW area. Like, it's so many dope artists here in Dallas that I can name.
Hey, man, let me say this to all you niggas and all you niggas out there. Right? We all are trying to come up, man. And we cannot build a hub if niggas do not support each other, man. Because trust me, it's some niggas I think are crazy dope out here. It's some niggas that I think definitely need a CDL. I support either way.
My perspective is, you dope, I'm dope, let's work. I get it. I totally get it. Like, you know, but you don't want to be driven by the money. Like, the money will come. At the same time, don't negate, like, what could be, because you're blocking it. You're basically putting the trees before the forest.
I don't, like, even think it's the money, though, bro. Yeah. Because...
So what you think it is?
Because I know. I'm going to tell you this, bro. I know a lot of these. Because
a lot of artists are coming up. Like, bro, everybody ain't got it like that. Like, you got your one or two where it's just like, okay, they up there.
I'm gonna tell you something, bro.
But for the most part, it's like, man, we just trying to make some good music, man.
I'm gonna tell you something, bro. A lot of these artists that's actually doing something, they're busting their ass. As far as these artists that you will see when you go to open mics and when you go to these local shows out here, man, because again, right, I go to shows that's big, small, in between, mega, all of that. You know what I'm saying? Like, When you go to these local shows, bro, I know a lot of these people, bro. A lot of these people went to high school together, bro. And a lot of these people have a high school complex. It wasn't then, so it's now. So it's like everybody's living their best life now. And it's like certain people have clicked up and have created something for themselves. And it could be a hub for themselves. They've created a hub for themselves. But it could be bigger if you wasn't still there. It could be bigger if you was to move forward and learn how to move and work and, you know, show love and, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, I feel like I'm a nigga that do what I want to do. Ain't nobody controlling me. And, like, I have no fear of nothing. So, if a nigga like me, who they can call arrogant and big-headed and all of that, can show love to everybody, you know what I'm saying? There's no reason why you can't, bro. It's people that I know for a fact don't like me, but I show love to them because, for one, that's the nigga I am, bro. Energy. Yeah. Lessons, bro. But it's business. If we are trying to make something happen, it's not just about you. It's about making Dallas the spot.
That is the bigger part. Like, I feel like, so the way Dallas is, I feel like it's a kind of like a mini, it's like a microcosm of New York. Like, how you had Nas, you had Jay, you had like you had all these different artists where it's just like, oh, yo, like, they come. But, like, my thing is, it's like, a lot of them came up beefing too. Like, my thing is, it's like, I want to bring all of our music together. Like, I feel like Dallas don't get the respect that it deserves. But, like, we done had a few people where it's just like, oh, like, you know, you think of Doc and you think of, like, Erica and stuff.
Shout out to Doc and Erica, man.
Yeah, for sure. But it's like, Dallas don't get, like, man, there's so many dope artists in the city. And I know, like, there's other cities too, like, you know, in the U.S. and across the world, like, you know, where it's like a hub working together with other artists to make it bigger than what it is. Even if it's like, all right, like, money getting in the way, or they'll trade song for song. Like, you do a song with me, I do a song with you, and then boom, like, you know, and make something happen. And networking, marketing, too, like, I figure something out on the business
like
side.
Like this, but too. A lot of people, again, it'd be really an ego thing, bro, because I'm the type of person, I'm not gonna lie to you, bro, if I don't feel like you can keep up with me, bro, I really Talk about it. Alright, he's nice.
Yeah.
And then it's like a couple people I'm like, oh, he's with me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because for me, and then again, it might be ego talking, but I feel like there's nice and then there's where I'm at.
Yeah, I don't feel like it's ego to an extent. I feel like it could get there, but to me, that's just the competitive side
for sure.
Of hip-hop.
Me personally, if I don't feel like you're up to standard, to my standard to be on my record, I'll produce for you.
Yeah.
Or I'll feature on your record. Bro, even if you want me pop up to your music video, bro. Like, you know that girl, Nezzy. Shout out Nezzy, man. Mm-hmm. Nezzy Momodu. Bro, I popped up at her video shoot, bro.
Oh, nice, nice.
You know what I'm saying? Just showing love, bro, because...
When was her shoot?
It was... July. Like, July. I want to say, like, the beginning of July.
Yeah. Okay. That's dope.
But, yeah, it was a dope video, by the way, man. Mm-hmm. I believe the song is called On God, man. Go check it out, bro. Yeah, man, just showing love, bro, because she, for one, she's nice.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? She's nice. I feel like, oh, she's, you know what I'm saying?
One of them ones.
One of them ones. So, I'm like, I want to go show love, bro. Mm-hmm. Even niggas that I don't feel like are necessarily that nice, man, it's just about showing love, bro. You give the things that you want to receive, and then you get the things that you give.
That's true. But never putting anybody down and being like, oh, you whack, or you did. But it's like, you can give constructive criticism too.
For sure.
Like, I've been in that situation where I thought somebody like, I don't think they rap as good. But I don't want to necessarily do a song with them. But like, man, same way, like, I'll record you, though. Like, come over to the studio, I'll record you, I'll get you some
but
studio
you time. Like, you can't give everybody constructive criticism. Because, like,
some people don't receive it well.
Or, but, again, if it's coming from somebody who's a supremely skilled person. Mm-hmm. Like, I value skill already. That's why I talk so big about myself, because I have the skill. So, if it's a supremely skilled person and you don't feel confident in what you're doing, you already know that it's really not up to snuff. And then the nigga that's really, really nice come and be like, you need to do this and you need to do that. You gonna be like, how bad, nigga, who you think you are? Like, nigga, I know how to rap, nigga, but it ain't even like that. It's just like, bro, I feel like, nigga, if you
but
did
see,
this
now,
or
that's, but that speaks to the arrogance, though, because if it, like me, I think, like, even somebody, so I had an artist over here. Remember I told you, hey, can we reschedule? Like, they came over to record. Like, I let them hear one of my joints because I was just like, man, like, I'm stuck on this third verse. Like, I got the hook down, I got everything. Like, literally, when I finished this third verse, song is done. And so there's like an 8-bar gap where I can't figure out what to do with it.
Right.
So I was just like, what you think? Like, give me your opinion. You know, what you think could go here? And so, and he was giving me, and I was just like, I never even looked at the song that way. I'm thinking like, just what can I say to, but I done already did 2 verses of just straight rap. So I'm just like, I want to mix it up, make it melodic, make it, you know, make it to appeal where you got something for the hip hoppers, but also you want to rock a stage too.
For sure.
Like, you say, I'm thinking of all those things, and I'm asking somebody's opinion, but it's good to get like an outside ear where it's like, sometimes you can get locked in your cage, in your bubble, in your studio, like, you know,
I got executive producers, man, and for one, I'm the Virgo in me, bro, I'm a perfectionist, man, so like, I make a beat. This is how I know I'm on the road, man. I'll make a beat and I'll play it. I'll be like, hey, what you think? Mm-hmm. I don't really like this beat. Man, you crazy ass, man.
Yeah.
And I'm like, alright, I got it. I still don't like this beat, I got it.
You may come back to that beat like 2 months later and be like, oh, man. Like, you know, you didn't like it then,
man.
But you got an idea, you got something.
Bro. And then it's not always the one that we pick.
Yeah, sometimes it's not for right now.
If you notice, a lot of times when artists like pick their lead singles for their albums that's coming out, and like they're trying to figure out what single they're gonna promote.
Right.
A lot of times it's not the single that they thought it was gonna be.
Yeah. Yeah, that remind me, so, you know, Method Red, The Rock Lover.
Oh, like, man, yo, for sure.
Method Man hated that song.
Why?
He didn't want it on the album. Like, he did not want that song on the album. I remember when I was watching the interview, and I'm just like, yeah, that song, that's one of the ones.
What's wrong with, listen, first of all,
Red was like, no, you got, we leaving this on the album. And then that turned out to be what it was.
Love Method Man, bro. I could rap all the words to the whole Takal album.
Yeah.
What the f is this nigga problem, bro? What the f, bro? Nigga talking about he want that. Nigga, that's the hottest record on the gym.
Right.
And I actually know that album. It's the Blackout 2 album.
Blackout 2, yep.
So, yeah, bro. Like,
I know their discography. Like, the Ha Ha soundtrack. And that, man, like, yo. Him at the Red Show. Remember that?
Yes. You know who's new? Well, not new, but he's just now getting his flowers, and I think he has a beautiful discography. West Side Gun's discography, man. Yo, like, it was a tweet that was like, who got better beats between Westside and Ross? He was like, come on, man, I love Ross, but this is...
I like Ross, too. Yeah, but...
Hey. Nah. Okay, Ross done had some misses, but some of Ross, as far as beat selection, some of Ross beat selection, that's the ones?
Yeah.
Them ones are the ones. Like, bro, Santorini, Greece is one of the most beautiful beats I've ever heard, bro.
Yeah.
No cap, bro.
Yeah, you know what's, even when I go to, like, somebody like Drake, you know what's one of my what I think is an underrated Drake song. So have you heard Omerita?
Yeah, for sure.
That song, yo, like from the lyrics to the beat to the beat, like I like that Drake. I like that
speaking
Drake.
Of,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah,
like this singing Drake.
Yeah, but like, give me that. Like I get your fan base, but man,
I'm gonna say two things about Drake. For one, Drake. If you're gonna talk about him and Pusha T, Drake, if you're gonna talk about the song and the art, Drake won that. If you're gonna talk about the scandal part of it, Pusha T.
The impact. The battle rap side.
Yeah, like the battle rap side of it. Yeah. You say,
Pusha T. Because he got personal. That. Yeah, yeah.
But the thing about Drake is, ever since that Quentin Miller, have not respected Drake's pen
the same.
And that bothers me, bro, because Drake's pen is literally top tier.
Yeah.
Like, there are not many people in this world that can hang with Drake. There's a couple people that's here. Like,
he's a marketing genius.
But we're talking about, but when I say rap, like, okay, I separate artistry and rapping.
You do have to have an overall package, but at the same time, it's like, man, what's being said, though?
You can't.
What are we talking about?
And see,
though?
That brings me to another point.
Okay.
Because, okay, it's a few bouts of disrespect that's being dished out that I don't quite like.
Okay.
The Kendrick disrespect. The Jay-Z disrespect. No, trust me, it's there. The Jay-Z disrespect, the Kendrick disrespect, and the Pac disrespect. You young niggas that lost your mind.
Oh, the young boys.
Marbles, son. Like, yo, let me explain.
But see, they gotta
niggas,
go
bro.
Back. They gotta
but,
do revisions.
But because no,
gotta,
it's not. It's not that,
check
bro.
The history.
The thing about it is,
check the files, man.
Hip hop is a youth thing, bro. For one, hip hop is always gonna be connected to the youth. So it's all about what the youth
That's
is listening to, bro. And this nigga Pac ain't put out an album in 25 years.
When I
so
first started rapping,
like,
I did my due diligence and went back and listened to.
But again,
like,
bro. But that's because
the Pete Rocks and the,
when we came up, we was in the transitional era.
That's
we still had actual rap. Like, we had common sense when we was coming up.
That's true.
Listen, when we came up, we still had niggas like Wayne.
Yeah, it was a different time.
Think about the mixtape run Wayne went on. It was rapping.
Yeah.
Like, it wasn't...
Yeah, all the dedications, all
dog.
Yeah.
And I ain't no disrespect to the mumble rappers and niggas that do the little A's and Y's, and I fuck with that shit. I do that shit from time to time. That shit fun.
Right,
That shit's fun.
Yeah.
But that's not, that brings me back to the Pac disrespect. Niggas say that Pac wasn't lyrical. It's about subject matter. Subject matter matters.
My thing was heaven and hard to find. Like, that was my joint.
Dude, man. God Bless the Dead and Toss It Up. Oh my God, bro, he went stupid on Drake in second verse.
Yeah.
Bro,
that's a fact. That's
you
a
ever
fact.
Seen the original Death Row the cover art for that album?
Yeah.
For the Machiavelli album?
Yes.
You know the original?
Yes.
You know, so you know what I'm talking
bro.
About.
Yes,
with the
bro.
Yeah, with the Dre?
Yes, bro. Go back. anybody that's under what we thinking here?
Bro, like 20, like 23, bro.
I was gonna say 25. So 23.
Let me say 24.
Anybody 24 and under, go back and do your history on this hip hop thing, man. Like it's before Wayne, it's before Ludacris, it's before, like, you know what I'm saying?
Before T.I., man.
Before Gucci. Yeah. Like who even like Jay and Nas, like that was like, a big
before thing. Before the game. 90,
yeah.
Go back before the game. Like start.
Like go back to game. Matter of fact, go on YouTube and watch a documentary called The Art of Rap.
The hip hop docu series.
I watched them all. Yeah. I'm a hip hop purist Your stage presence, that was the first thing I told you too. Like, other than the Joey comparison, I was like, your stage presence is amazing.
And
like,
nigga said,
when I saw, like, the way you was moving, and then you had the cigarette, and then you just had the, like, I was just like, yo, he's captivating,
man. Nigga
like,
said, I look possessed up there, like I was possessed by a ghost. Nigga.
Yeah, no, like, nigga, that's just you, in your artistry, man. Like, you was in your
bag. That's
just
who I am, man.
I feel like you've embraced something that a lot of artists have not. Like, and it's just full control, full composure. You know, like, I believe in what I'm saying. I believe in what I'm doing. Like, and it, like, I saw that. You know, even when you got, and this is no disrespect, but what gets me a lot too is when even poets do this more so than rappers. Poets do this a lot when they read from their phone.
Oh,
that kills me. Please memorize your rhymes.
Let me tell you something, bro.
Because you cannot embrace a show when you're doing this. You can't, like, you have to look in every face, like, look in people's eyes when you engage in the crowd and all these other things. And, like, you can always get better, but, like, some people have got that more than others, but that would be my one. We talked about constructive criticism. Memorize your rhymes, please.
Yeah, for sure, like, man. Think about it as a business, man. Like, imagine, you go to Coachella or some shit, right?
Don't do that, Coachella. Like, right. Beyonce,
to,
like.
Imagine you go to Coachella, right? And, like, Beyonce come out and, like, the
don't
fireworks are going up. And then she pull out her phone and start reading that shit. You gonna be like, man, I paid all this. You better start dancing, like. It's a business, man. Yeah. Like, for one,
but people gotta believe in you.
You gotta believe in you. Gotta believe in you, man.
To make them, like if they see like, ah, they're not really, you know, they'll snap, they'll support whatever. But that's it.
My thing is this, bro. I believe that my gift comes from the Most High, bro. Like, my gift comes straight from. Like, I take no credit for what I do, man. Like, it has to. There's no way that I'm making what I'm making, bro. Like, it's too good for it to come from me. Yeah. There's no way that I'm doing it.
I love that.
So, I feel like it's not even my belief in me. It's my belief in the Most High.
Mm-hmm.
And that gives me the belief in myself that I can do. That's why I don't fear anything, bro. That's why I have no fear, bro. Mm-hmm. Like, I done been in situations where I done had guns pulled on me, bro. Situation, nigga, I done car accidents, nigga, no seatbelt supposed to flew out the car.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, like, bro, I done been through too much, bro. I have no fear, like, only ambition, bro. So that's why when I get on stage, mm-hmm. and you're like, that's because you're seeing a nigga that is absolutely fearless.
Right. Like I done been through the tests.
I never felt more at home than when I was on stage, man. Mm-hmm. Like, and
that's a fact.
I've been on stage since I was
the same way.
Man.
Yeah. Like, so for me, it's like, like, I feel like, you know, it is something I've been getting better at too, is stage presence. Cause what I've learned is that it's more than just the words too. Cause yeah. I'm a huge wordsmith. Like I said, my favorite rapper is Lupe. But I come, like, you know, I listen to like the Immortal Techniques and all these different kind of art, like, but like where they're quote unquote lyrical, right? But also the presence. Like, where's the presence? Where's the, like, I heard Kanye say, like, if I put a beat on or if I'm making a song, if I can't envision this song rocking 80,000 people stadiums, then it can't go. Oh, like, yeah. You know what I'm saying? And it's just that mentality too, because Kanye can rap. Like, he got fire song, but it's like, you looking at all angles of artists.
You gotta think about it, bro. That's another thing with my music. And I'm really giving out too much goddamn sauce. But I make music that's made for stadiums. I make music that's made for arenas. I make music that's made for big places. Like, the music that I made and that I continue to make is not made to be played where I'm playing it. In some spaces. Because in some spaces, it's a lot smaller. But when I go to the actual big spaces that I made it for and I do those shows, I get the response I'm looking for.
Okay. Yeah. One last thing I want to know about, like, your music. Like, so what, because I was talking with my homeboy the other day about this too, is that kind of like when you went back to the inspiration piece, when you was talking about, like, you got to be inspired. Well, I was saying, like, so when we were younger, we just wrote raps.
It was just, I'm better than you rap.
Yeah, like backpack rapping, all that kind of stuff, battle rapping. Because I grew up on battle rap, still love battle rap.
I love battle rap, man.
Yeah. So if I'm right, that's why this album taking so long. But I feel like when it's done, people going to see why, though. You know what I mean? Because it's like, I'm not forcing nothing. It's like, I'm going to let it come to me when it comes to me.
Speaking of which, I would love to play the album off camera, man.
Oh, yeah. Bro, I got some joints I want you to hear too.
For sure.
Yeah, so we definitely going to do that.
But
it's like, for me, it's like, I got to be inspired to the point where if it don't come to me, like, let's say I'll sit down and listen to a beat and I won't write a word. Like, I'll just listen to it. Okay, cool. I got it. But then one day, so the last thing I uploaded on Spotify, the motif joint, I wrote that in. I heard the beat, wrote it in like 10, 15 minutes and put it up.
For sure.
You know what I mean? It came to me where it was just like, it was effortless. I didn't have to think about it. That's the kind of kick. The last three uploads, the little singles I've been putting out, that's where it's been coming from. It's just been coming from the soul, like coming from God, where I'm just like, I'm not sitting down writing or forcing nothing, where I would love to sit down and write, but lately that's been my music. Like, when it comes to me, I got it.
For sure.
So for you, it's like, my last question to you is like, okay, how do you go about, since you say you got to be inspired, do you write as much as you used to? Or is it more so, it just has to come to you? Is it like that same way? Or what's your process for making new music now?
For me, it's really weird, actually, bro. Mm-hmm. A lot of times when I make music, it's separate. Mm-hmm. It's a separate process. Writing a lot of times is different from the actual beat making and recording and things like that. Mm-hmm. Whenever I'm in album mode is when I start to do beats and actually sample search and do all of those things. Cause I'm like, okay, I'm in album mode. I made like 2 albums in a month and a half.
Right.
Like, crazy, like crazy, crazy working. Like, bro, making like 3-4 beats a day. Like, mixing, mastering, like, okay, I like this, I like that. But that's album mode. As far as writing, it happens when I'm inspired, and it can only happen when I'm inspired, because I would never want to give anything that's less than 100% of myself.
Okay.
And I've always felt like the best music came from emotion. Like, no matter, like, the reason niggas love Youngboy so much is because he has a song for every emotion. You know what I'm saying? So the best music definitely comes from emotion. So if I'm at a point where I feel something, like, something's really bothering me, like, I see something on the news or I experience something in my life and it's really, really bothering me to the point where I don't know what else to do about it.
Right.
Okay, now I'm finna go write.
Okay. And I can feel that.
And again, I don't I don't just write rap, so I'm not just a type. Like, I, of course, I have raps in the tuck.
Yeah, right.
But when it comes to making an album, I don't just write raps for the album and then just go pick.
Right.
What I'm writing for the album is what you're getting.
Right.
So, it has to be an inspiration, bro. Like I told you, bro, I made this album I want to play for you, bro. I made it in less than a month.
Mm. And how many tracks?
Eight.
Mm, nice.
Eight. But I made it in less than a month, bro, and that's what making beats every day, writing, mixing, mastering, the whole thing.
Yeah. In a month.
Yeah.
Nice.
But it's because in that month, I was so locked in because every day it was, I still feel this.
Right.
I still feel this. Okay, now I feel this. Okay, I feel this. Mm. But every day it was something. So yeah. Every day it was coming. And then I go months without doing anything at all.
Mm. I can feel that.
Like, what I'll do is I'll go back and I'll master.
Mm.
I'll mix of this, you know what I'm saying? Work on this album as far as just mixing, because they're already done, so just work on them as far as mixing. But as far as creating, man, I won't create nothing for months, bro. And then I'll just get in it's like a spell, bro, where I'm just locked in for like 2-3 months straight, and I'm just cranking out. Like, bro, like niggas think they generate a lot, bro. I generate so much music within that time, bro. If niggas need to be like me and SZA and kidnap the hard drive, because it's so much music, bro.
Right.
And y'all in you never hear.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I feel you on that. So, yeah, man. Like, this has been a dope conversation. Oh, like, yeah, we definitely gonna kick it off camera. We gonna, you know, listen to some music, talk some more. But before we get out of here, man, just tell the people, like, where they can find your music and what you're working on next, any shows you got coming up or anything you want them to check out, you know, get that to the people real quick.
Oh, yeah, for sure, man. I actually just did this festival, Greg's Fix, man. Shout out to Greg's. Church of the Universe of Love and Music, man. Yeah, I just did that a few days ago. That was actually really, really cool. Shout out to Greg. Shout out to Didi. I actually just did this gig with K104. Man, everything, every social media, YouTube, all that, man. GOATWUZI. I got this album coming out, Black Panther, man. It's coming out toward the end of the year, man. This is better than anything you ever wrote.
I'm talking to these niggas,
you niggas ever wrote. Yeah. I swear to you, bro, this album is a classic album. Like, my mama said this was a classic, bro.
Mm.
And niggas be like, well, that's your mama. My little sister said she wanted to get into the music business. My mama told her she needs to stick to her day job. So I know if my mama said this is a classic album,
yeah, she got that ear.
It's a classic album, bro. She listened to like DMX and Pac and Big, so she knows classic albums when and she listened to Kendrick, and she knows.
Yeah, my mama knows.
Yeah, mama knows.
All right, man. Well, we gonna get up out of here. We about to chop it up off camera, but hope y'all enjoyed this episode of Sound Check. I am Altitude. This is the homie Wuzi. Check his stuff out. All of his stuff will be in the description box below. This has been another episode of Sound Check, and I am Altitude, representing Building Their Minds, the Hip Hop Workshop. And until the next one, I'll see you guys when I see you guys. Peace. One love.